Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Pre-Market News and Views by In-the-Money Stocks. Today is May 15, 2018. My name is Nick Santiago. Thank you all for tuning in this morning. All right, starting off the day with the S&P 500 E-mini futures, you'll see the futures are down about 11 and 3 quarter points. Right now, they're trading at 27.19 a contract. So all in all, futures are a little bit on the weaker side right now. We'll see how this market plays out today. We've had a good run over the past week. Markets are into a ton of resistance. We are overbought as well. So we'll see if we do get a pullback. But the big news today is really going to come out of bond yields. Bond yields are soaring. They're up over 5 basis points after the economic data was released at 8:30 a.m. And right now, bond yields on a 10-year U.S. Treasury note yield are about 3.048%. So they're up over 5 basis points today. And again, we are now, believe it or not, at new all-time highs, or I shouldn't say all-time, but I should say, I believe, new since 2014. So we're at new 5-year highs here on yields. So we'll see how that plays out. And again, we'll see how the market reacts today. But all in all, bond yields now are trading, again, right around that 3.05% level. So pretty good pop there. And that's all based on the economic data that was a bit stronger than expected. And that was released at 8:30. You can check it out for yourself. In the meantime, futures are down. And we have some stocks in the news. We're going to start off with the big one today. Big retailer here, Home Depot. Home Depot under a little bit of pressure. Stock closed at $191.08 yesterday. Now trading at $185.60. So good little pullback there for Home Depot. Nothing terrible. I think the stock needs to retreat a little bit more. So we'll see how that plays out. In sympathy to Home Depot, you want to watch LOW, which is Lowe's. That's trading down just a touch. Closed at $86.58. Now trading at $85. So we'll see how that plays out. Full disclosure, I do own put options on Lowe's. Next up, we want to take a look at Symantec. SYMC is the ticker symbol here. Stock got hammered last week, if you recall, on an investigation. That was actually crushed, I believe, on the 11th of May. Today, it is getting a pretty good little bounce back up, but still nowhere near the $28 level where it was trading last week. So little uptick there for Symantec after earnings. I don't think the CEO could really comment on the investigation, but nonetheless, stock is getting a little bit of an uptick. So we'll see how that plays. Next up, we're going to take a look at Vodafone. Ticker symbol is VOD. This is on the back of earnings as well. Stock closed at $28.37. It is now trading at $27.31. The only level that really gets me interested in this name would be a move down to around 26 and a quarter. If it got down there, I think there is a play there. So keep that on the radar, and we'll see how that goes. Let's take a look at Agilent, ticker symbol letter A. This is the medical device maker. The stock closed yesterday at $69.21, now trading at $64.75. So you can see that big, big haircut there. There's still a fair amount of support around the 63 level. So we'll keep it on the radar. I'm not sure if we'll play it in the morning, but we will take a look at it around 63 bucks. There could be a play there. We've really got to see how it gets into that. Nonetheless, we'll keep it on the radar today. Let's take a look here at VIPS, V-I-P-S. This is VIP Shop. And again, this stock closed at $15.09, now trading at $12.75. So this is a pretty big haircut here. The only level that actually gets me interested in this name is down around $9.60, maybe even a gap fill area around $8.75. So those are the only two levels I would be looking at right now, and we'll see how that plays out. Let's take a look at shares of Tesla this morning, TSLA. Looks like there's another investigation going on with the cars regarding an accident. Looks like the stock right now is trading at $284.20, closed at $291.97. So Tesla coming under some pressure. But again, it's not down all that much, but it is lower this morning. We do have some upgrades today. VRX, which is a stock that's been treading water for quite a while now, a couple years, getting an upgrade today. That is trading at $21.45, closed at $20.81. Micron also upgraded today. That stock is trading at $53.60, closed at $53. So we'll see how these all play out going forward, and we'll just take it slow and steady. Let's shift gears here a little bit. Let's go over to the gold market. Gold is getting absolutely annihilated today. Gold is down 18.5 points right now, trading at $1,299 an ounce. If you take a look at the GLD, you'll see that's trading at 123.19. This closed at 124.49. So very, very big haircut for gold, and that's on the back of a stronger dollar. Remember, bond yields are popping. That means the dollar is getting stronger. The dollar has been on a tear to the upside. This is something that we picked up back in January. We're out of it now. We just got out of it last week. But nonetheless, it is still strong and looks to be going higher from here. Let's take a look here at crude oil today. Crude oil is on the tear today as well. Crude oil moving up by 67 cents to $71.64 a barrel. If you take a look at the USO, which is a good ETF to track crude oil, that's trading up around $14.49, closed at $14.38 yesterday. So oil continuing to soar higher. A lot of that could be on the back of geopolitical events. The dollar is stronger today. Gold is down today. And we have bond yields ripping to the upside. So again, it's going to be a very, very interesting session to say the least. But nonetheless, when you have 10-year U.S. Treasury note yield soaring and roaring right now, that could be problematic here for the markets potentially. So we'll see how this all shakes out. With that being said, everybody, I want to wish you all a great trading day, and we will see you all on the charts. Take care now.